So let's move on to the US, and we're going to talk about things I can't just make up. And of course, all of you heard the shocking news right after our broadcast last Thursday night that the president of the United States announcing very early in the morning hours that he and First Lady Melania Trump were infected with COVID-19. The next sequence of events from Friday until today have been startling, and I'm going to give you a rundown in case you haven't been following. So Friday morning, Trump gets the virus, and with no surprise, the White House is super quiet about his diagnosis. They're not saying anything. Nobody knows what's happening. And think about this. He's a 74-year-old, mildly obese man for U.S. standards, whose diet includes McDonald's. His favorite meal, according to CNN, is 2 Big Macs, 2 Filet-O-Fish sandwiches, and a small chocolate shake. He also loves meatloaf. Melania, meatloaf! And an excessive amount of Diet Coke. Because too many calories in Coke, you got to drink Diet Coke, right? So naturally, there were a lot of concerns about his health. And on Friday, it was reported that his oxygen levels dropped to dangerous levels. So he boarded his helicopter and he was moved over to Walter Reed Medical Center nearby for further monitoring. And this is very strange because there are a lot of facilities in the White House, but he needed to go to Walter Reed for all those facilities. And of course, you know, when he's in Walter Reed, just like my dad, get me out of here. They don't even have cable TV. The food is terrible. The bed is terrible. And Trump was reportedly bored and wanted to get out. He recorded a few messages. And then on Sunday, now remember, he was incredibly infectious with COVID. So on Sunday, with his Secret Service detail, drove across the street from the hospital just to greet his admiring fans. I love you, Donald Trump. Oh my God, oh my God. He gave me COVID. Can you sign my ventilator? On Monday, allegedly against the guidance of some of his top advisors and doctors, Trump returned to the White House, and instead of walking through the ground floor door to his residence, he walked up the grand steps of the South Portico. He took his mask off of his face and he waved to America. Let me show you this. This is a video made by the Lincoln Project, a group of anti-Trump Republicans. Let's take
it. Don't cry for me, White House staffers. The truth is I will infect you. All through my tweeting, my mad existence, I broke my promise, won't keep my distance.
And remember, the guys that made that video are Republicans, but they're not Trumpers. And so a lot of friends here in Mexico have been asking me, Dan, did he stage this? Did he really have COVID? And I can't believe that he would. And if he did, it would have been a really bad strategy because recent polling suggests that Joe Biden's lead is growing in many battleground states where the race is close. So Trump did not get any sympathy votes out of this. In Pennsylvania, Biden is up by 13 points. And in Florida, he's winning by 11. In Iowa, he's up by 5. And for the first time in this election, CNN has put Biden over the 270 vote threshold needed to win the election in their electoral map projection. This is good news for Biden. And yes, I understand. On this day 4 years ago, Hillary was leading and Trump still won the election, but she was only leading by 3.5%. And there are some polls that are reporting that Biden has up to a 16-point lead among likely voters. And no, I'm not saying this is a sure thing. Remember the Russians, and you know how I couldn't sleep for a year when I was 6 years old watching Drago kick the living crap out of Rocky? And there is something in American politics called the October surprise. In 2016, it was Trump talking about grabbing a woman's what-what on videos and Hillary's emails. You remember that scandal where Hillary was sending emails from the wrong server and essentially lost the presidency? Who knows? Maybe one night Mexico will miraculously build the wall, but this time to keep coronavirus out. Or maybe we find out that El Chapo's lover, Kate Castillo, is really Joe Biden's illegitimate daughter, making El Chapo Joe Biden's brother-in-law. Who knows? We only have 26 days left to see.